Okay, so we are at stack-based BFS. So this is about stack-based BFS. You have to scan a tree, you have to print a tree level-wise. This is layer 1, this is layer 2, this is layer 3, this is layer 4. So it should print the tree like 1 first, 1 first, followed by 2 1, 2 2, 3 1, 3 2, 3 3, 3 4, then 4 1, like this. So this is 2 1, 2 2, 2 3, 3 1, 3 2. So horizontally it has to print the tree. Okay, so we'll go by disclosure on this stack based BFS. We'll search for stack based BFS. Okay, so this is scene. So there is a disclosure on this developer.ibm.com. Click on it. Okay, what is the current scenario on this? The known solution to the problem is you have to maintain extra queue. You have encountered the node, push its children to the queue, keep popping the queue to print the node, and then simultaneously push all the children into the queue. Okay, so you go in a loop, and then you pop the queue, print the node, and then push all the children on the node. So it is something like you have to maintain a queue. So in queue, the first element would be the node 1. So it root node, that would be 1. Okay, so it would print 1, then it will iterate through all its children and then it will push in the queue. So next will be 2 1, then 2 2, then 2 3. So these will come in. So they will come next in the queue. Okay, so your queue pointer is here now. Queue pointer is here. Now it will go and pop up the first one in the queue, that is 2 1. So it will print 2 1, then it will push its children in the queue. So that would be, so queue is growing. You can see that is, So now there is a new entry in the queue. Those are children of 2-1. So 2-1, because of 2-1, this came in the, because of 2-1, this came into the picture. Up to here. Okay. Now the pointer would okay, so this pointer will go away. Now after printing this, there will be pop in the queue, as you can see. So it will keep popping the queue, print the node and push all the children inside it. So now it will come here. Now it will print 2-2 and push 3-4, 3-5. Now it will go to 2-3, print 2-3 and push 3-6, 3-7. Okay, so your queue will become like this. Three, four, three, five, three, six, three, seven. Okay. Now, queue pointer will come here. Now it would print 3-1 and then 4-1, 4-2 will go come into the queue down the line. So this way you are printing the tree in BFS. What is problem here? Problem is you have to maintain extra queue. This is extra queue. So queue you have to maintain, that is extra. So extra memory is required. How much memory is required? Okay. So when you are at layer 3 and all nodes in layer 4 would go in the queue. So this is very much equal to n by 2. So if you have four billion entries, that comes to 2 to the power 32, then you need to have 2 billion size queue. That is the biggest. Okay, so that is a big problem. Second is you have to read write in the queue, that takes extra time. Okay, size is one issue. Second is read write time to the queue. This is time factor, this is size factor. Okay, this is for binary queue. If it is not binary queue, there is no restriction on the binary queue. It is a radix queue kind of thing. Radix tree. This is for binary tree. Radix tree. Then problem would be even worse. Then it would go to size would be near to n. Okay. Okay, so what is the solution proposed in this scenario? So solution proposed is, this is a tree. This is a tree. This is at root level, first layer, and then second layer, then third layer. So in new algorithm, it will be recursive. So recursion happens on a stack. So no need to maintain a queue. No extra memory is required. And this would parse the tree from the layer level, like it will come to layer 1, print the node, then it will go to tree and search for layer 2. It is something like, okay, so there is no queue now. Queue fundamentals are over. No extra space is required. So what it would do is, it will print the, so it will maintain two things. So from the root node it would enter. From root node it would enter, okay, and its target would be to print all the nodes at layer 1, so root node will get printed, okay. Then it will enter again, so target would be one. It will enter again at root layer and its target would be layer 2. So everything at layer 2 would get printed. Again it will enter the root and it would target at target would be three. So layer 3 would be printed like this. Okay. So in this solution, so we'll go to the solution little more. So this is the solution. First you target the root, then target the next layer, then target the next layer, and this way layer by layer you keep printing. Okay. So let's see the algorithm. Okay, so algorithm is very small. So this is the algorithm. Okay, so in this algorithm there are two things you can see. One is called target, one is called level, and another is the node. Okay, so it comes with the target. Okay, so at the beginning the node is this, target is 1, zero, level is 0, so that is the first layer. Okay, so if it is matching the matching target level 0, it would print this as per the algorithm. Okay, so it will print node, it will go to root, target 0, level 0. If target is greater than level, it's not greater than level, it would print the child, it will return true. Okay, now it would go back and same route it will start give target as 1. Target 1 means now it has to print everything at layer, everything at layer 2. Okay, so now target is target is 1. Okay, so it will start with level target is 1. 1 means it has to print this layer. Now it will enter in the algorithm target 1. Okay, and current level is 0. So this is level of this node. So it will enter from the root, that is level 0, but its target is level 1. Okay, target is greater than level. So for all of its children, you can see all of its children, it will call print tree again. Now each children one by one. Okay, and level plus 1. So what, the target is not changing. So this is root node now. In recursion, now this is the root node. Okay. Now it will come back in the algorithm and target is found as level. Okay, it will go and just it will go in else statement here and it will print the node. Okay, as per recursion come back, then it will print this. As per recursion come back, it would print this. Okay, so it got printed. It will come back in the while loop here again. Now it will enter from the root itself, but target will grow. Now target is 2. Target is 2 means now it has to print everything at this layer. Okay, so from here it will enter and target and level would not match. Target is greater than level, target is 2, level is 0. It will come here, target is 2, level is 1. Okay, now it will come here. Target is 2, level is 2. So this would get printed. It will come back here. Okay, as per the recursion, because it is iterating all the children, then it will print this. This is behaving as a root node now. Then this would print this. It would come back here. Then it would come back here. It will go to next children. Level is not matching. Here level is matching. It will print 2. Come back here. Come back here. Then here level is not matching. It will go down. Level is matching. Okay, come back here, come back here, all children are over. You can see it is iterating all the children, I equal to count. Okay, next time it would go with the target equal to 3. Okay, is it quite clear? Now It will enter from here only, from the root. Now it would enter from here. Now while loop print tree, target is 3, and then it will see target is 3, level is 0, not matching. For all its children, it will iterate, not matching. All its children, it would iterate, not matching, because target is 3. It would come here. Now target and level are matching. Okay, come back, the next children. Come back here, the next children, target is not matching, go down the children, it is matching. So this way it would print all the level. Okay, what is benefit of this approach? Okay, so we talked about size. So size wise, no extra queue is required. So lot of space you save. So if your queue is of 4 GB, then no 4 GB extra queue is required. Okay, 4 GB if it is a binary queue, maximum layer would be 2 to the power 32. So maximum level it will go, that is 32. Okay, and in one layer, if there are recursion 3 parameter in a function, there are 3 parameter in a function and 4 byte for each, 12 byte. So total maximum memory at a time it will consume is 12 into 12. 3 are there, return value and everything, make it 5. 5 into 4 bytes into 32. Okay, this would be less than, I believe, 1 kilobyte. It would be less than 1 kilobyte. Okay, and this is much less than in another approach, that is 4 GB. Okay, that is 4 GB. Okay, so we are saving space a lot. Okay, this is space wise. Time wise, there are a lot of read and write. You maintain a queue and lot of read and write are going on in the queue, that you are saving. And minimum time you parse the tree, you can see that each node behaves as a root in the recursion. So no need to go back. So every node is able to print its children. So in the real scenario, when we see the experimental data, space wise and time wise, so when time is calculated, it is much, much faster than the previous approach. Okay, so in time analysis, we can take worst case scenario, that is level 27 level, it is calculated. Children count is 2, that is binary tree. Time taken by queue based approach is 43 seconds and this much microsecond. Time taken by stack based is 5 seconds. So it is around 8 times faster and it is numerous time better in space area. So space domain, time domain, stack based BFS is far ahead. Okay, so memory, how much memory it use? So using GDB, all calculations are made. Okay. Okay. Stack-based BFS is available through Manning website also. www.manning.com. In this website, go down and you can find a stack-based BFS tree. From here also you can click and go to the paper. Other way is in the website, you come to research, click on research. In the research, go down, then you will find this paper. Here you will see, you can see code. Here you can see code. Click on the code. It will take you to GitHub website. And then click on a stack-based BFS. Here you have two source code files, you can see. There are two source code files here. One is stack-based BFS.c, one is stack-based BFS space time. So this is the test case and this is the algorithm. So you can try the test case. If you click on this, you will get the so this is the test case, how to compute time and size domain. And this test case will verify the algorithm. And this is the algorithm, actual algorithm. Okay, thank you.